Hello and welcome to Filmcopath. Today we have a very special guest for a very special podcast. We have Sudhish Payyanur from Monsoon Media YouTube channel. Sudhish, sir, thank you for joining us. And before I go to you, I'd like to say a few words about you. Sudhish sir is a lecturer at St. Thomas College. And he has done his PhD in Chemical Sciences at Academy of Scientific and Innovative Research. However, we are actually acquainted to him because of the wonderful and fantastic job he's doing on YouTube through his channel, which is Monsoon Media. It is possibly one of the most followed YouTube channels in India, and it is really a great fortune for us that we have him today here with us. Thank you, Sudhish sir, for being here today.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir.
Before we reveal the topic of today's discussion, Sudhish sir, tell us a little bit about your journey in the YouTube. How did you figure this out, and how did you think about making a YouTube channel like this?
Okay, thanks. Thank you. Before starting, I should say my English is not that good. Maybe some problems will be there, so you can manage that one. Now, into YouTube, it was quite accidental. I was watching all the movies. Maybe per year, I will watch at least 150 to 180 films in theater. So it's my hobby. Any time, I would like to watch movies. So after watching the movie, I used to write something in Facebook when the social media in 2011 onwards social media is there. So after that, actually, this Monsoon Media was started by other two persons. They were working in Doordarshan together for the time. And after that, they started this Monsoon Media. So they just saw my writings. And once they asked, can you do video? I just told, I never did that. So we can try. If it is going well, we can cross that. So I just started at that time. Okay, some audience were there. Then suddenly, that also from a Mohanlal film, you know.
Okay.
More people came. Maybe it's like it become viral, 1 rupee. So after that, okay, more audience came. So now it's going well. So maybe in the starting time, I didn't take it in a serious way, you know. It's just watching film and just telling about that. Later, when I realized that, okay, others are watching, others are commenting and all those things, then I feel that, okay, I should be more professional, something we have to do. And then started learning in the sense, what's happening in the sense. I mean, we cannot do in that way because my subject is chemistry. But getting time means like that it's going. It's good, I think. Now it's good.
Also, tell us a little bit about your doing other language cinema in Malayali. How do you have good audience for that? Do Malayalam audience are interested in other language, English movies or Hindi movies like that?
Yes. Initially, we were doing only Malayalam. But at that time also, I was watching like Tamil, Hindi. Most of the movies I used to watch in theater. So then later, we feel that, okay, we can tell. Even though we are telling in Malayalam, a lot of audience are there. Big releases for Tamil movies, you know, 400 theaters in Kerala.
Yes.
Like Vijay movie, Rajini's movie coming. Then we started, generally this... for Tamil movies, a lot of audience are there in Kerala. And when I was staying in Trivandrum, you can see that in Hindi movies also, a lot of people are coming. It's houseful shows, especially Salman Khan's Dabang also houseful shows. Okay. You can realize what is the situation.
Uh-huh.
So then we realized that after this this telegram, all those things came. So people are access to all the films, like Korean, Spanish, no language barrier. We'll get subtitles. Then we feel that, okay, we can review that also. Then this theater release, especially Malayalam, Tamil, Hindi, and English, not all movies, maybe restricted. But later, when it will come to the online platform like Telugu, Kannada, all the movies that we are watching, and we're just telling, okay, good, bad. You can see, especially when we are discussing about Kannada movies and Telugu movies. You can see the path-breaking movies in the last 2 years. Like, a lot of very good movies are coming from Telugu industry and Kannada industry. Before that, we are just feeling that, okay, just fight, just songs, Telugu cinema is over. Mm-hmm. And Kannada just over drama and all. But now you can see that, like, Agent Sai Srinivasa, Atreya. I loved those movies in Kannada also, like Gandu Mutte and all those movies.
Right.
I feel that we can introduce these movies to our audience also. Again, people are getting good experience.
I think that is some exceptional work which you are doing, that you are actually introducing so many people, and yours is not a small channel. So many people are watching, and so many people are able to experience different regional languages. cinema of different languages, which is really, really great work, Satish. I really appreciate what you're doing. Of course, today in Connected Through Cinema, the topic of our discussion is drum rolls, Mohanlal. And since we have made our Malayalam video and we made a podcast on Mammootty, we have got death threats that if we don't do a Mohanlal podcast, then we will be brutally murdered. So we are not going to take that chance. So to cover Mohanlal and give his intro is I think it's like showing a candle to the sun, but still I will try before we start the discussion. Yeah. Of course, we know he is a great actor, but he has also done, he's a producer, he's a playback singer, distributor. Also, he has done a lot of philanthropy work. He has worked in multiple industries, apart from Malayalam as well. More than 340 films. Mohanlal has won 5 national awards, 2 best actor, a special jury mention, a special jury award for acting and an award for best feature film as producer. He has also won 9 Kerala State Film Awards and Filmfare Awards South and numerous other accolades. The Government of India honored him with Padma Shri in 2001 and Padma Bhushan in 2019, India's 4th and 3rd highest civilian honors for his contributions to Indian cinema. In 2009, he became the first actor to be awarded the honorary rank of a Lieutenant Colonel in the Territorial Army. He received his honorary doctorate from Sri Sankaracharya University of Sanskrit in 2010 and from University of Calicut in 2018. Now, can there be a more prolific bio of a person than Mohanlal? That tells you all about. I mean, it took me more than half a minute to read through whatever was there. So, truly amazing.
One more sentence I can tell. In every Malayali, there is a Mohanlal. From childhood to any age, in every Malayali, there is a Mohanlal.
Yes, absolutely, absolutely. So, Sudhish, sir, let me start with you. What is the most standout aspect of Mohanlal for you? What do you really, really find at him, which is not present in other actors?
No, actually, we cannot just tell about Mohanlal alone, because 2 superstars ruling this industry for the last 40 years, we should say. Mm-hmm. And when we are considering about Mohanlal and Mammootty, that is the main difference. When we are considering about Mohanlal, we are telling about Mohanlal means in any character, there will be Mohanlal. We can tell it is in a word like Lalism. So his mannerism somewhere you can see in Mohanlal, and that people liked any, people loved it. In the other case, in Mammootty, there is no Mammoottism. He is going to that character. You cannot see in one film double role is there, means you cannot see that is Mammootty, this Mammootty. It will be very different. He liked to do movies like that, but in the cases, Lal is taking character to himself. He is not going to the character. He will take the character to him and then he will start like exploring like anything. So that actions, that mannerisms, people love like anything. One more thing regarding the studies related to Mohanlal and Mammootty. People used to tell, I forget his good name. Mohanlal is considered as like Lord Krishna. You know about Lord Krishna. And Mammootty is considered as Lord Rama. Is Maryada Purushottam, that character he built every time, depends on directors and all those things. But in the case of Mohanlal, these mannerisms people loved, and after 40 years also, when we are discussing this time, 1980, December 25, that Manjil Virinjapookal, his first movie has a prominent role. Before that one movie released, but later, it just one show, then it cancelled out. Then Manjil Virinjapookal, we are celebrating the 40th year in December 2020. We can see that started as a villain. Up to that time, you cannot see that in any industry. Maybe now it is possible playing a villain role, and people are getting attracted to that. Like nowadays, no hero and villain, I think. But at that time, in the initial, before 40 years, he's playing a villain. And people are more attracted to this villain. They don't care about the hero. Now also, when we are discussing about Manjil Virinjapookal, that movie, people are, hero was there, but people are not interested. Now, we are talking about Mohanlal, his mannerisms, like a childish character, like we may feel like that, but it's not exactly like that. So, from that villain stage, the next movie, I think, one of the main role was Uyarangalil, that written by M.T. Vasudevan. He's also a very prominent writer, that Randamulam, about. So, there also, he did a complete negative role. So, that is a very path-breaking scene that up to that, Jayan was there, Nasir was there, Satyan was there. they were doing heroic roles only, but just good person, a good character. Okay, they're fighting for justice and all those things. But here Mohanlal came and they're doing negative roles and the people are getting attracted to that guy. Means, so see, he started like that. Then after that, you can see like Drishyam, Lucifer. In a, Kerala is considered as a very small industry in the sense it's not that big audience. Very small state. But there also, he showed that, okay, 50 crore is possible. Not 50 crore, 100 crore is possible. Not 100 crore, 200 crore is also possible. So that's only done with Mohanlal.
Right, right.
Great. A textbook, you know, big textbook, encyclopedia, something like that.
Yeah, I think the way you said it, really, the difference between Mohanlal and Mammootty, that the character, Mohanlal makes the character his own and Mammootty goes to the character, is so subtly and so well put. I think I haven't heard such a pleasant and clear explanation between the two actors. Before I go to Arup and Arnob, I would like to tell our audience that our knowledge of a Malayalam cinema is like a drop in the ocean. So we know that we have not watched a lot. Sudhish sir is a very senior in that case. So he has watched a lot more. So we will try to get a lot of information for him. So if we miss something and if we mispronounce, please forgive us from the beginning. Or just this much I want to tell. Okay, Arup, what is your take? Why do you think that Mohanlal sir is so popular all around in Kerala?
Yeah, so I mean, the way Sudhish sir actually explained the difference between Mammootty and Mohanlal is great. You know, the most subtle way to put the right perspective. I think I would echo very similar things. So my first introduction to Mohanlal was when I saw Sazae Kalapani, the Hindi version, you know, long back. I was in my school days, I believe. Then I saw, you know, a few other Hindi movies. I saw Company. I saw, there was this A Wednesday Tamil version.
Unnai Polo.
Yeah, right. So in all those movies, I saw him as a very soft, you know, soft-spoken, sober person, you know, very down-to-earth kind of a person. And then I saw Spadikam. And then I was, oh man, how could this man do this role? I was stunned. And then I, you know, kind of after Spadikam, I discovered many other roles. And I saw this man's, the variety of roles this man can do is incredible. He can actually, you know, the way Sudhish sir said, any character role, he can make him himself. It's not exactly the rowdy you would see in any other movie, but a rowdy, a Mohanlal kind of rowdy, or a Mohanlal kind of police officer, a Mohanlal kind of, you know, a villain. So that's what stands out for me.
Right. Coming to Arnob, what do you think? For you, what is the standout aspect for Mohanlal?
Yeah, I think like Sudhish sir has already explained it so clearly. And as Arup was saying, for me, introduction to Mohanlal was Company, which I believe many of the North Indians got to know about him from that. And obviously, he did a great performance there. But like he was like more the soft-spoken, very strong police officer, but soft-spoken one. And then I saw Iruvar maybe after 5-6 years and I got stunned. Just off late, like rewatched Iruvar, then Boeing Boeing, and then Devasuram. Now that kind of explained the range Mohanlal has. Now as he rightly said that Mohanlal gets, like Mammootty gets into the character and Mohanlal helps the character get into him. It was like that, understanding that into all these three films. And if someone tells me that what you have to say about Mohanlal's acting, I would say go and watch Devasuram. Because apart from the comedy part, you will see the whole range from the start to end of the movie. The how the character changed and how the emotions changed and how he acted on that. Now that explains all for me.
Right. Actually, from whatever you all have said, I really don't have much to add. Only thing I will say that how can a person be still so relevant after 4 decades of work? From the way, like Sudhish sir said, that he has been working for so long and still, like he said, he is giving still after, even after Drishyam nowadays, he has still given 200 crores and 100 crore films. And that makes him such a, I mean, big influence apart from his acting also. He is actually too much more of a person than just as an actor. So that is really a very, very standout aspect, because in a way, he is one of the persons who is actually one of the pillars of the Malayalam film industry, one would say. He's there. Sure. You can bank on him. You can bank on him for films to do well. He will take the responsibility and you can take it and take it to the bank. Whatever he's doing, take the money to the bank, it will be a hit. So that brings me to my second question. And it is difficult for us to understand as outsiders, as Sudhir sir will be able to tell better. Why do you think that there is such a frenzy around Mohanlal? There are Mamuti fans, but Mohanlal fans are a little bit different from Mamuti fans. Mohanlal fans are, you can say, maybe comparable to Rajinikanth fans in Tamil, for Tamil industry. So there is that kind of a, if one might say, there is a hero worship kind of a thing for Mohanlal. Sudhir sir, what are the cultural roots for it? Why do you think such a thing happens?
No, actually, from the history onwards, I can tell, maybe his career onwards, the two important directors that he worked, three we can tell, but main important two directors are Priyadarshan and Satyanand Thikar. So their films are even, like Kalapani, and some movies are okay, but other movies, most of the movies are like comedy. They are just representing the common man, their problems, how they are tackling it out. Just middle class family, most of the time they are representing. So people are more easy to relate that guy. And when they are going to the theater, they're going to celebrate, you know, like Boing or even Devasuram also, they're celebrating like anything. But at the same time, when we're considering about Mammootty, his movies, most of the movies with Joshi and I.V. Shashi, P.G. Vishwambar and K.G. Jor, they are somewhat serious movie makers in the sense they are always doing commercial movies, but the character will be somewhat rough and tough. But that's why people are still enjoying Mohanlal and Mammootty. They never cross their path. They are just parallel lines and they are okay. So when we are in Mohanlal's case, also a lot of movies came with I.V. Shashi. So after this thing came, maybe in 2000 like that, so this common man is becoming somewhat supernatural. Not supernatural, like Superman-like. We have a
superhero,
Batman, Spider-Man like that. But in case of Malayalam, you can see that a lot of characters like Mangalasiri Neelakandan, you can tell in Devasuram. Yeah. Then Jagannathan, like in Arandamburan. Then Induchudan. No, somewhere they failed in their life. You know, that is a character buildup. But after that, they become emperor. Like that, you know. So this journey people love. You know, even sometimes they cannot be like that, but they can visualize, okay, I will be like this. So they're celebrating that one, you know, especially his this action, Lalatans. Okay. Then just Mund, those things. Then some chains will be there. Okay. Just maybe some cigarettes will be there. Maybe some punch dialogue will be there. So that eventually turned to having a mass audience. So they can really celebrate, especially after Drishyam, this Pulimurugan film came. Actually, when we are considering from a normal Malayali point of view, the story is not outstanding. Story, we know this will happen. This way. But Mohanlal is doing action sequence like anything. So people never watched in 30 years of career, never watched this man is doing like this. He's jumping, fighting and all those things. So people are ready to enjoy these things. A different Mohanlal came. So it turned to be this one. When coming to Lucifer, so people can see that all his mannerisms, you know, his look, his dialogue delivery. So all his mannerisms, Prithviraj just put into one film. So people feel that, okay, this is something extraordinary. That's why, you know, he know actually how to, he know the pulse of audience. Maybe that's the right word.
So do you think it is more of a accessibility thing that Mohanlal is more of a common man's hero? And maybe where Mammootty could be more accessible to maybe a little bit, you can say, I think that intellectual is not the right word, but maybe who want to watch serious cinema. But Mammootty is more accessible to the common people, and that is why he has this kind of a image of what he has.
We cannot tell in that exactly accessible word. Accessible, it means I can access to this guy, that guy like that. Maybe
relatability? Do you think relatability is the word?
Yeah, that will be a factor. But the ultimate thing is that this is in the first layer. In the first layer, people are more getting attracted to Mohanlal. When we are again digging that, it will go to Mammootty's layer because it's somewhat more emotional content. Mohanlal is considered like this, I told. Then when we are considering about Mammootty, it's elder brother, some character like that. Like, mm-hmm. So he's having that image. And the one thing is that when we're considering Mohanlal's career, there are some directors he never worked with them. That's a big loss to Malayalam industry. That also, I should say, like K.G. George. He did, I think, 19 films, and you can see that among that 10 films, still people are discussing, you know, the best political satire, the best crime thriller, the best socio-political one, like that, K.G. George. But Mammootty has a great chance to work most of his films. Even though very small role, maybe one scene also, he used to work with that guy. Yeah. Then Adoor Gopalakrishnan. He's one of the director means Malayalam cinema to the world level. Maybe Bengali people maybe heard more about Adoor Gopalakrishnan, like Madhulikal. But Adoor never worked with Mohanlal. We don't know exactly. Then another director is Jayaraj. Jayaraj, I think before 2 years, he got the best national award, best film, that for Ottad. And Jayaraj also never worked with Mohanlal. But these directors always work with Mammootty. And it's in, you know, class mass. We cannot compare because both are M. It's for Malayalam industry, Mammootty, Mohanlal, both are pillars. You know.
Right.
But audience-wise, and you can just tape them. When we're considering Tamil industry, Rajinikanthan, Kamalhasan. You can see, you know, audience-wise it is, and how acting-wise. We cannot just compare in a simple word. We cannot compare.
Yes.
It's like that. But audience-wise, and one more thing is that when a movie is coming and it's getting an average report on the first day, and if it's a Mohanlal movie, it's easy to hit the box office. Nothing to worry. It's okay, getting average. Okay, done. All profit, everything done. Just to run. But in Mammootty's case, nowadays, it's not like that. Maybe it should be a very good film. So audience-wise, I should say that Unda, one movie came last year, 2019. It was a very good movie, but in the box office, it didn't make much punch, you know.
Right.
So that is, but in the case of it was done by, you know, Mohanlal won't do like that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, similar situation came for Mohanlal. If it's getting average review also, it will hit the box office like anything. People are more... no, they don't get bored while watching Mammootty and Mohanlal. They are always enjoying me also, you know, last maybe 20, 25 years. I'm always watching Mohanlal and Mammootty.
Right.
Still excited to see when new movies are coming.
Arup, would you like to add something to what Sudhishtha said?
Yeah, so, I mean, I kind of agree with whatever Sudhishtha is saying. Just wanted to mention one director and, you know, the Mohanlal's collaboration with him, Padmarajan. I have watched three of his films. I love Padmarajan's movies. And what I felt is, you know, a film like a Thuvana Thumbikal or, you know, Namakku Parakkan, Munthiri Thopukkal.
Munthiri Thopukkal.
Yeah, so these were so progressive movies. I mean, a movie made like Namakku Parakkan or Thuvana Thumbikal made even today would feel like ahead of its time. And that Mohanlal played those characters, you know, lead characters who are so progressive, who are so different, makes a lot of influence on the society itself. You know, if I see my superhero, if I see my, you know, star, my hero being playing that kind of a progressive role, I would also feel a bit differently. I will also feel a bit out of the conservative way of thinking that is more popular in an Indian household. So I think that speaks a lot about the man. And, you know, that collaboration between Padmarajan and Mohanlal, I really, really love that. Very, very progressive movies. Very difficult. Even if I talk about, you know, Bengali industry or a Hindi industry, which we kind of consider more liberal, I've hardly seen so progressive movies, so effortlessly done. It's not only about being progressive. It's about being so effortlessly being progressive. You know, the heroine Namakku Parakkan, he is kind of considering, hey, I mean, whatever happens to the girl, I love, I will be with her. I do not need to worry about what has happened with her in the past, what has happened in the present. The love aspect I am having for this girl is the utmost importance for me. That's so rare, even in, you know, and those movies do not feel like, you know, they are movies which are like parallel movies. They are very mainstream. They're very accessible. So I really feel that influence of playing those kind of characters, being a superstar, has an impact on the society. And I really, really appreciate Mohanlal for doing that.
Yeah. True.
Yeah, I think, yes, his movies with Padmarajan, actually, from what I felt, that's a very difficult name, Namakku Parakkan Munthiri Thopukkal.
Thopukkal, yeah.
What does it mean, Sudhishtha, first? Could you tell me what is the meaning of it?
No, Namukku Parakkal means we can, the place where we can live. Mundiri Topugal means this grapes.
Okay, vineyard.
In the vineyard, living in the vineyard. Okay, where he used to work.
Yes.
Where he used to work. Yes.
Yeah, so I think one of the standout aspects of that, since you mentioned Padmarajan, I would like to add that for most of the movie, nothing critical is happening, but you still cannot take your eyes off from what actually is happening on the screen. You have to look at the way from the first scene only when Mohanlal comes in with his truck and he's making the sound and then getting his mom up. That the whole character, the way he builds up, a normal person, thoroughly normal person, nothing heroic about it, but still he creates you and engages you just when he's eating roti, you still want to see him. He's looking after his vines and you still want to see him. So that is really somebody with that much of a capability within himself can only do. Also, a lot of kudos should go out to Padmarajan, actually, like the way he has made those films, in spite of being mainstream, casting Mohanlal there.
Even in Thovana Thombikal, and a person loves two girls and he is split for choice whom he should consider continue in his life. I mean, that's so natural, that's so obvious. But even then, hardly do we have a movie in India, maybe a handful, where we have this conflict, a man split between two girls. And the best part I like about that movie is he does not shy away from telling one about the other. He tells the other about, I also like her. I do not know if she comes, what will happen? How will I react? Unbelievable. We have seen so many, a man is hiding his ex-girlfriend or someone with him who is having now an affair from the wife. And there is this kind of, the whole conflict builds around, okay, will the wife be knowing about the other girl and what happens after that? Here it is not that. They know each other. It's about what the man does in his life. It's a beautiful film. I mean, that collaboration is really, really very close to my heart. Padmarajan and Mohanlal.
Yes, yes, yes. And you can see that along with Padmarajan, you have to mention some other writer and director like Bharathan.
Okay.
They worked like Thaivaram, one of the thriller movie, but it's just placed in a place, hills place, and there are very less number of characters, main three characters only. And that was written by M.T. Mm-hmm. Then after Bharathan, one writer is Lohitha Das, and he only gave a lot of movies like Dasharatham and Surrogate Mother and all those things you can see at that time, Malayalam film. And that director, Sibi Malayil only did Kiridam, and for that he got that special mention for National Award. And with his movie only, that the other movie, he got Sibi National Malayil? Award. He got National Award for the other movie. Oof.
Bharatham?
Bharatham. Yeah,
that music, one was done by
Sibi Malayil and Lohitha Das combination.
Yes.
They're very good writers, and these guys, especially Mammootty and Mohanlal, they were ready to explore like anything. They don't like Arup just mentioned. It's not like how people interpret like this. They don't care. They just want to get the character, so it's there. They want to explore like anything. So these writers, especially in that golden era, 80s to 90s. So these many very good directors, very good writers. They explored Mammootty and Mohanlal like anything in all the way. And then people now we just feel that, okay, now any new character is possible for Mohanlal Mammootty, then okay, new writers will come, new characters will come. They will do that one also. 40 years is very long span, three generations they are influencing.
Right.
That is right. That is something, sir, we were also mentioning in our video about Malayalam cinema. There's a lot of celebration about Malayalam cinema today. The films that we have, Kumbhalangi Night, Lee Jojo's films. But, the Lohitha Das, the Padmarajans, the K.G. George, they might have paved the way that we are here today. It's not in one night this happened.
Yeah. I, Sudhir was talking about Dasharatham, and I like, obviously, that is one movie I was discussing with Arup, that it was in 1989. the topic about artificial insemination, it was so bold. So in that note, obviously, like the Malayalam industry and the movies they have made, they're so much ahead of its time. And that's one of the reason we also were not from Kerala, would like people in Kerala to just watch all those movies from 80s that has paved a Kumbhalagni Night or a Lijo Joseph movie that's happening today.
One more film that we have to mention when we are discussing about Moolal, we already mentioned about Iruvar Andor. The other one is Vanaprastham. Maybe you watched
it. Yes, I was about to say that, Sudhish sir, we want to know your view about Vanaprastham. Yes, good point. Please continue.
Yo, Vanaprastham is just a class, no, apart from one class movie is not possible, you know. And one interesting fact is that when we are discussing about this Kathakali, that movie, Mohanlal is a Kathakali artist. So to become a Kathakali artist, it will take years, you know. You have to practice your face, everything, the, you know, bhava, mudra, everything you have to discuss. And within a short time, he is learning this one and he is just showing us this is possible. That's really wonder, you know. Something Mohanlal is not a human being, he's something from that, it will feel like that. So that's always, you know, I think in Indian cinema nobody did like that. It's when we are learning more about Kathakali, then you will realize that how much time it will take to learn these things and how much effort you have to put for these things to be in a perfect way. Then in the screen he's showing in a perfect way means nothing to tell, just salam bye.
and in Vanaprastham, I mean, those scenes where he is dressed as the Kathakali dancer, they are amazing. Man, what do I say about that? But even when he is not, he is at his home, he's just, you know, lying down talking to his wife or his daughter. His face, his expressions, unbelievable. I mean, there were scenes where he's having this, eyeliners and he's talking to someone. I felt like, you know, I for a few minutes, I felt like I'm looking at Marlon Brando. That kind of a face I got to see when I was seeing Mohanlal in that one. Unbelievable. See, it's very fortunate of us that Vanaprastham comes out with subtitles and we could enjoy that film. Unfortunately, the Mammootty Shaji Karun collaboration, Kutti Shrunk, I have not found a subtitle for that, so we could not watch that one. I have heard that
is also a very good movie. It's all about magical realism and all those things.
Yes.
Maybe you'll get
We wanted to mention to you also and to other fans also, like Sadayam season, Vastuhara, all these movies
Sadayam.
Which you are not able to see. So we request the fans of Mohanlal who are watching to create subtitles and so that we could also enjoy and see and understand, because that is one of the problems because the accessibility of the older films, specifically the older films, is an issue for us.
Sadayam, I have heard so much. It's a great movie, but then without subtitle, not able to see, watch it.
Now, for Sadayam, MT got National Award, I think so, for Best Screenplay. And nowadays, they are remastering these old films and uploading in Amazon Prime. Maybe some old movies came, 1980s movies, already in Amazon Prime, not Mohanlal's movie. Maybe later, all those movies will come, then you can enjoy, definitely. Maybe
hopefully,
2 to 3 years.
Now let's talk about some of his non-Malayalam work. And when we talk about non-Malayalam work, the first thing that will come to everybody's mind is Iruvar. Maniratnam, A.R. Rahman, Mohanlal. So I think a more dream combination has not been made. And when I think about Iruvar, I look at the difference in the Tamil industry and the Malayalam industry. So there is this, in Iruvar, there is this glamour, there is this beautiful music, and along there is a more theatrical aspect to it. And in Kerala, in the Malayalam industry, we find more of a realistic aspect to it. So how was Iruvar, you think, perceived or seen in Kerala, and how did it actually became this massive, massive film? Sudhish sir, if you would tell us.
No, the acceptance is not a matter, I think, because at that time also, most of the Kerala people watching Tamil movies and enjoying, especially Rajinikanth's movie and Kamal Haasan's movie, most of the movies are big hits in Malayalam also, because it's in Trivandrum, you can see it's a mixer culture coming to Palakkad and all those area. In my place also, in my childhood days, in my school days, I went for Anpesi one release show, you know, you remember at that time.
Okay.
So it's okay, Tamil is, at that time, in B-class, C-class theater, most of the movies like masala movies, like maybe with fight and dance. So people like more that movie, and acceptance is not a problem. But it's great thing that, okay, our star is doing there and getting acceptance. That really, especially in Iruvar, Company and Janada Garage. These three movies I really loved in Mohanlal's other language performance, because they are also accepting and we can also enjoy the same. You know, we are not feeling that, oh, he's doing something like that. We can also enjoy, they are also enjoying. So it's the language is, the cinematic language is all over the same. You know?
Right.
Company was a hit in Kerala in that sense, because like over on Pan India in terms of box office, it did average number, but we got to know the acting prowess of Mohanlal.
No, it's not a hit in Kerala. At that time, Hindi movies are not, we cannot tell it's hit or something like that. But people recognize that movie and most of the people watched it in theater. That only we can tell.
It's he was brilliant in that movie.
He was brilliant in that.
Yeah.
I remember that dialogue at the last point, you know, when Ajay Devgan is wounded and he's telling, why don't you do that? And he is with a very, you know, very strong accent. He's telling, main bhi chandu nahi hoon malik bhai. It was so beautiful, you know, that whole character is coming out in that dialogue, the way he was talking.
Right. Also, if we could talk a little bit about Kalapani, because I think that was also, I think as a movie, Priyadarshan movie, making a movie which is actually talks about the realities of the Indian independence movement and at such a grand scale, and it has shown things which mainstream cinema I do not think still can show, with the way and which probably a cast which is pan India, with language, with dialogues in Malayalam, dialogues in Hindi, in English, in Bengali, and Mohanlal of course being the central protagonist of it. So how did you like Kalapani? What was the aspect of Kalapani which you enjoyed the most?
No, Kalapani, it's the not only Mohanlal is working in that movie, it's the production, how it happened at that time. That's still still thought-provoking, how it's they managed that. And along with Kalapani, you should mention one more movie, that's Guru. I don't know whether you watched or not.
Yes.
These two movies, like Kalapani is about freedom movement and all those things, but you just mentioned about no language barrier and all those things. Then Guru, you can place anywhere, anytime. But unfortunately, these two movies were flopped. That's very sad. We don't know exactly that time. A lot of good movies were flopped at that time for Mohanlal and Mammootty also.
Right. Guru makes so much relevance today. I mean, it seems, you know, it's a more relevant movie today than it was when it released.
Yeah.
Once we have to tell you something. We had interviewed Adur Gopalakrishnan, I think, a couple of months back. And we asked this question, that why haven't you worked with Mohanlal? And he said that Mohanlal generally plays good-hearted rowdies. That is of course, his point of view, Adur sir. And he says that he might not be suitable for my films. So I think sometime we should give to the good-hearted rowdy roles which he has played. And I think maybe we can talk a little bit about Kiradam, Spadikam and Devasuram, these three films. If I specifically like you to talk about Kiradam, because from that, the Gardish was made in Hindi, which was a very Jackie Shroff and Ambish Puri were there, but initially it was made in Malayalam. So Kiradam, so what are your thoughts about that?
No, Kiradam is actually representing a middle class man, though he's trying for a job and whatever the, you know, it's, when we're considering about his family, his socio-political things and all, then anybody can relate, you know, anybody can relate that possible. And we can consider these movies. So when we're considering about Kiradam, you can relate all those things and it's happening, and we are very sad about Sethu Madhavan. But when we're coming to Spadikam, okay, his childhood days were like that, but from that he escaped and now he's like a hero. He's a rowdy hero. Then people are celebrating that, you know. See, you see the irony. You know, people are sad about Sethu Madhavan, and in the other case, the other guy is also become a rowdy and he's celebrating, and people are also started celebrating about with Aadu Doma. So it's a relatability, you know, the character wise relatability. And Mohanlal's, most of the characters were like that. It's easy to understand, you know, his mannerisms, his what's happening around him and all those things. People can easily understand within maybe 1 or 2 seconds when we are seeing him in the theater. That is the best thing about Mohanlal. We already know Mohanlal. As I mentioned, we already know Mohanlal, and Mohanlal is becoming rowdy. Mohanlal is going to rowdy. It's not like that. Mohanlal is taking that rowdy to himself, and now it's Mohanlal rowdy. So it's easy to relate and communicate. The communication with the audience from the screen is very great about Mohanlal in that perspective.
I will never forget the dhoti fight scene of Spadikam. I mean, you know, Mohanlal is not the, you know, the lightest man. He is a heavy man. And with the effortlessly, he, you know, he's fighting and the dhoti comes off and he's okay with that. He's fighting along with that. And later there is one character who says, I think it's his brother-in-law character, Ashokan. He says, I want to watch your dhoti fight. And he says, yes, yes, next time you come, next time I fight with the dhoti off, I will call you. No worries. He's so effortless. I mean, I cannot believe this was that police commissioner in company. You have to watch that fight scene to understand the brilliance of this man.
Yes, in one of the scenes, he used the dhoti as an accessory also. Like jumping police officer and throwing him in the water. Again, slowly he will take around his head and he will put him down like that. That was really, really amazing scene to enjoy. Arnav, you want to add
even
something?
Even in the climax, even in the climax also, if you see the fight, like he was, I'm wearing a shorts now. I was just wanted to show that, like he was fighting, he had that, like that knife in his hand and he was pointing at the police and he was standing near the cart and at the same time, the left hand, if you notice that, he was just trying to do pulling the dhoti or doing something with that. So that came organically. He didn't forget that, like that dhoti is a special part of his character. So
unbelievable.
That also speaks a lot. Yeah.
I mean, the effortlessness. I am amazed with that. Yeah. You know, how do you fight with a dhoti first, and then you are a hero? Even people will watch you. People are like celebrating you. They will pinpoint any, you know, false stepping. And you keep on doing that fight scene. I do not know how many shots it took to get it filmed, but that's incredible.
I would like to now ask you, Sudhir sir, although we have been talking about Mamutty and Mohanlal both, and I know the answer to this, you will not give a good, clear answer, but still I am asking you, who is your more favorite, Mamutty or Mohanlal?
The most controversial question in Malayalam cinema.
I would say don't fall into this trap.
I know this question, but okay. Definitely, from childhood onwards, I feel my hero is Mamutty at that time. But later, when we are learning more about films, we realized why, you know, that has the influence, the character influence that I felt. I already mentioned Mamutty's character, how it was there. Then Mohanlal's characters, how it was there. The influence only made. Generally, in Mamutty himself, in one film, that Billu Barber, Malayalam version.
Yes.
He told, okay, you like me, but generally, actually, you don't like me. You like my characters. You like, maybe Inspector Balaram you like. So actually that one, but I realized later. Later, I feel that, okay, Mamutty has his own way. Mohanlal has his own way. I am enjoying both. So there is nothing to discriminate. I enjoy Kamal Haasan, along with I enjoy Murali, along with I enjoy a lot of actors.
It's a trick question. It has a very useless question, but I just asked that. And but anyways,
yeah, it's okay.
Anyways, there is one of the things which we all need to realize as cinema lovers who will also watch this video, that we do not need to make one bad to praise the other. We do not need to go in that area of comparison. It is people are there are great actors. Both of them have given so much for us to enjoy, and for us also many subscribers, Mohanlal and Mamutty. So we are specially indebted to both of them.
I used that word before. Mamutty himself told, you know, there is no point in comparing an argument. We are just parallel lines. Mamutty has his own way. You know, he's. I will tell you one movie.
Yeah.
That is Paleri Manikyam Oru Padira Kolapathakathinte Katha. That movie is actually based on a true event. that is in 1957, when the Kerala government started, it was the first registered rape murder, I think. It's about that movie. Maybe you will get the subtitle. Definitely you should watch.
Okay.
And it's the story is happening after maybe 30, 40 years. The present Mammootty is coming and investigating those things. On that day, he bought. You know? That's the relationship.
Okay.
Then you can see that three Mammootty are in that one, and two are villains and one is hero. And he's not actually hero. And the two villains you should see, you can't tell it's Mammootty because you didn't watch Mammootty's movie like that one. Then the climax when Mammootty is coming, and in between, in interval when Mammootty is coming, he's the most negative character that he did in his life. He's an aged man. So you cannot compare, I think. He always want to do something more in a character, Mammootty. He already told like that. But Mohanlal means, okay, getting a character. Okay, just make it like this. Okay, fine. We can enjoy both.
There is no,
we can enjoy.
Of course, of course.
I mean, cinema viewing is a perspective, right? I say, this is the best actor in the world. What does that mean? I mean, it's for me. It might not be for the other person, right? And yes, the greatness, I think, about these two actors is, for decades, they have been coexisting. They are, yeah, you know, they are giving all the audience, not only the Malayalam audience, everyone around the world, so much of thrill, happiness, joy, passion for cinema. That's the best part of it. I do not remember having two superstars, you know, two equally strong superstars reigning the industry for so long.
Yeah.
They are people, mm-hmm, you know, they are both above 60. And still, we see people fighting over them. That itself means how great these two people are.
Yes.
Right.
Yes. And so much mutual admiration as well. Like in every movie, all the movies, they will give small hints. If I remember in Perambu, he talks about Mohanlal. Mammootty talks about Mohanlal. And then here, when I saw, I forgot.
Tanmatra.
He talks about Mammootty. That's why Amitabh Bachchan then comes to Mammootty. So you can see that there is a mutual admiration between both of them. And that
so
is
many they have worked together. I mean, there are so many movies they have worked together.
It's around more than 52 movies they worked together. More than.
Mm-hmm.
Amazing.
And in most of the movies, like equal roles, you know.
Mm-hmm.
No hero, no villain perspective. Equal important roles.
Yeah.
Yes.
And there also you can see Padmarajan's one movie that is Kareela Kattu Pole.
Yes, a thriller. Yeah.
It's a thriller movie, and Mammootty as a director, and he was get killed, and Mohanlal is coming as an investigating officer.
Right. Oh, right. Yes.
Okay. That's a good recommendation. When we discuss about Mohanlal, one of the movies which we have to discuss, of course, is Drishya, and it is because this movie has been remade in so many languages now. There's been Tamil, there has been Telugu, there has been Hindi, and now there is a version being made in Sri Lanka and in China.
Chinese.
Yeah, so there are so many versions. But still, we have tried to watch a few versions. For us, I think nothing beats the Malayalam movie experience. Like, I think we have also made a video about it where we talk about why Drishyam, the Malayalam Drishyam is appeals to us the most. So, Sudhir sir, tell us, why do you think? Do you also think that the Malayalam version is the best, apart from being the first one? Why do you think that possibly it is the most enjoyable than all of them? What could be the reason for that?
No, I feel that for any movie, then when it is remade, there are so many restrictions because when we are talking about Drishyam, the director Jeetu Joseph know what actually George Wooty is. No, his premise, what he's doing. And the character was built by Jeetu Joseph. And that was acted by Mohanlal and it came. When we are placing this character into another one, then it's very difficult. Already the character mannerisms are everything there. The premise should be remade, reworked. So always there will be some mismatching problems that I feel. And Drishyam is the original version. That's why I watched Drishyam in Malayalam and Tamil only. But I like both, especially for Tamil audience. It should be somewhat more sentimental. Kamalhasan did very good. You know, even Malayali audience will tell that it's overacting. But I feel that for Tamil audience, it's like that. Their way of expressing and all those things we can see in other movies also.
Mm-hmm.
So, but the original version is always great always. And you can see that Drishyam 2 is already, shoot is over.
Yeah.
Yes. Maybe it will come in OTT, we don't know exactly. And what happens to George Uti after these things, how he is surviving and all those things.
We are all pumped up for that.
The thing is that when... Now, when I watched in theater, before the first show, people realized that it's a family movie. You know, trailer came like that. Mohanlal is taking a bicycle and going, some dialogues, some songs. So it's a family movie. Okay, just we are going to watch a family movie. But later it feels that it's something, okay, it's giving more pressure. And in the climax scene, you see that everyone in the theater just stand up and give a clap. That's, you know, in my theater experience in the last 10 years, I never watched such an experience for any other movie. Even big movies came, big hits came. But in Drishyam, that climax punch, you know, when you're just leaving out of this theater, you'll feel that standing out and giving clap. That is the evidence should be like that, you know.
Absolutely.
What about Drishyam only? One thing that I feel about Mohanlal, whenever I see him in any of his films, is this character is thinking something. This character is always having something going in his mind while he's looking at someone else. There's something going in his mind. And that particular feat of him came out in Drishyam. Drishyam is actually about a character who is telling something, thinking something, and planning something else. So that suited him so well that, you know, the movie experience got heightened even more.
Right. However, post Drishyam, we talked about that. So, sir, you said a few things about his movies like Lucifer and other movies which came out, which have been highly successful movies at the box office. People have watched it and it has they have grossed a lot of money. But if we might say that after Drishyam, we haven't seen a lot of Mohanlal the actor. We have seen Mohanlal the superstar, of course. But possibly we have not seen the Mohanlal the actor. What do you think is the reason? Do you think he's not getting good scripts or whatever?
I'm from an outsider making this point. Maybe it's my only perspective. Fans, I don't know how they will accept or no. I just mentioned about Unda. No, Mohanlal may not do that one film. No character.
Or Peranbu.
Peranbu chance is there, but Unda, it's very difficult. Maybe Unda is the political, all those things, let it be there. Maybe Peranbu also we can consider. It's Mohanlal become a brand, you know? Apart from actor, star, and all those things, became a brand after the Drishyam. So it's all about business. So I don't think he will do movies like Devasuram or something like that. If he's getting some character-driven movies like that, I don't know whether he will do or not. But as an audience, I always want to watch movies. But Mammootty, anytime you can expect such movies, maybe nothing will be there. He's like character-wise is only character-driven movies. Maybe Mammootty doing, especially the example is Unda and Peranbu. But Mohanlal, as a brand, he has not limitations exactly, but others can. As an outsider, we can tell that it's about limitation. Maybe he can do wonders now also. I don't know.
So
the one biggest thing is that Odian, when it came, we feel that it will be a path-breaking movie in Malayalam, but all of us were disappointed. He did a lot of work, his physical change, losing weight and all those things in Odian, but it didn't make much more impact in box office and in audience point of view also. But Lucifer and all those things, I think his coming movies also somewhat more mainstream commercial movies, like Jeetu Joseph, one movie is still pending. After COVID, maybe they will start again. Ram. And after that, they started this Drishyam 2. And now he is working in Arat, that is with Bhuv Nikishan. He's also a mainstream filmmaker, full fight and all those things. We don't know. That's very sad for us also. We always want to celebrate the actor Mohanlal, but celebrating the star Mohanlal. It's okay. That's also good.
Maybe that's good for the Malayalam industry, because Pulu Murugan is the first film that grossed 100 crore. And I have seen that after that, in 2016, it was Pullu Muruga. In 2019, it was Lucifer. In 2018, it was Kayam Kullam Kochuni, like, which was though Nevin Pauly was the main lead. All has grossed 100 crores. But I mean, yeah, somewhere Mohanlal superstar supersedes Mohanlal, the actor, you know. Yes. Recently, yes, also, yes. I tried to watch like Oppam. I thought that had a great demise and all. Execution was, I mean, yeah, it was not like Drishyam, I would say, in terms of the trails and all. Even villain, we missed the old Mohanlal. At least I do miss.
So, sir, are you saying, like, say in a Unda, where Mammootty is playing a character who is fallible, like, there is this scene where the firing starts and Mammootty is just doing nothing. He is holding his heart and he's sitting, you know, he's taking a beating. He is not the, you know, strongest or the most, you know, courageous man around. He is a common man. So Mohanlal is not able to play a common man anymore because of the burden of the industry. Is it something like that?
Yeah,
Not image. It's industry driven like that. You know, he may be able to do. He will do, but the industry a lot of restrictions from here.
Get it.
Yes. I think one of the something which happens with Aamir Khan now, like although Aamir Khan tries to experiment a lot in Bollywood and tries to do different things, but he will surely work in movies which are sure to gross him a certain amount of money because there are so much banking on him. Like there are producers and there are other houses. So if you see, we haven't even seen a trailer of Lal Singh Chadda, but the phrase, already you can hear, how do I know the name Lal Singh Chadda? It has just come through word of mouth and the viral marketing of whatever they do. So there is so much expectation riding that it is difficult to risk anything, which I think also happens with maybe Mohanlal.
No, actually, nowadays also audience want to celebrate the actor Mohanlal only. You know, they're always eager to wait his acting potential. You can see in villain, lot of emotion scenes he did very well.
Yeah, but yeah, villain is like, but still, the villain as overall movie, it's
that's right. In acting perspective, I told some good scenes. Yeah, acting.
Even Oppam, there were some good scenes.
We talk about, you know, movies after 2000, where Mohanlal has really a remarkable acting, I think we should talk about Thanmatra. He was amazing in that one, you know, that character of a schizophrenic man. I think he actually got an award from the Medical Association, IMA, if I'm not wrong.
Yes.
For playing so subtly a schizophrenic character. Schizophrenic, not, I think.
Because Black also got released. Black got the national award, but Amitabh Bachchan mention about Mohanlal after getting the award.
I mean, the transition, when he is okay, when he's fine, he's such a smart, such a, you know, he's kind of an ideal family man, an ideal parent, an ideal worker, everything. He's teaching the principal of a college how to teach your children. And then the same man, the coming down, the transition, it was such heartbreaking. It was such a beautiful movie.
No, when we are discussing about Mohanlal films in this 1 hour, there will be a lot of movies that we missed, you know.
Of course.
From 300 films, more than 300 films, at least 200 films should be discussed, you know. Right. missing.
So then, Sudhir sir, we have to do 48-hour long podcast then. Like, we will have to take a bath, come back, and then we have to continue discussing. But yeah, Arup, I agree with you with Thanmatra. Specifically, when the fallibility comes in Thanmatra, when we realize that something is wrong with him, and the transition from that super confident man to somebody who is a little unsure, that was truly amazing. But before we let you go, at least from what we discussed today, can you tell us about your, maybe if I ask you to pick two scenes of Mohanlal, which is favorite? Your favorite two scenes.
Which we haven't discussed yet.
Maybe. If you can say what two scenes which make you feel so good about Mohanlal the actor or Mohanlal the superstar, whatever. What two scenes will you pick?
Yeah. One is strictly personal. No, when that movie haunted me in my childhood days onwards. That was movie about movies Pakshe's butt. No, he was an IAS officer, but he is married to a lady. She is from very well family, and his family life was very broken. And he is escaping from there, and some stories. And in the climax, he is just looking, and his old means in what we can tell girlfriend. Not old girlfriend, not after he was not able to marry her, he married, and his family life was broken. And finally, in the climax, he want to marry his old girlfriend. Then they are meeting, but he was not able to do, and he is losing again, and he is going back. At that time, he was just looking. So that look haunted me now also. You know, maybe possibly I have that film in my laptop. At least I will watch that climax in today, you know. Some looks, you know. That is the first one. That is strictly personal. Maybe others don't like, others may not feel that it's a great acting moment or something like that. Second one, it's very difficult. But then also I felt that it is Sadayam and Dasaradam is there. But I'll pick Dasaradam climax. You know, in between his child and that lady's husband is there, and between that shot is there. It's I don't know what he feel like that, you know, we don't know, but his mannerisms, everything feel that you know, you should think what I have to do, something like that. The shot is there, so it was a very exciting moment. When I were, a lot of moments are there, but when I, you just asked, suddenly I felt that these okay. are the two moments.
Okay Arup, what about you?
So many, but I would speak about one scene from Devasuram where he has actually deceived and got Revati to dance in his courtyard. He told it would be in a temple and Revati came, but now he has made him dance in his courtyard. And while this whole dance and music is happening, the expressions Mohanlal is giving, I mean, you will like go and thrash this man. He is you know, playing the tune of the music at the same point of time. He is just enjoying the, you know, the defeat of this lady. He is making faces at one of the co-singers who is there. He, of course, you know, later in the movie, he becomes a very different person. But that whole music piece, Mohanlal is an impersonation of a devil for me. And I love that. And another scene again, you know, Tanmatra is so close to my heart. In Tanmatra, there is one scene where he is not locating the file, office file. He has actually put it inside the refrigerator. And now he has got it. And he is not able to believe that he has done that. He is getting angry on his family. At the same point of time, he is starting to question himself. That expressions he got in his face. Now, I feel an old man slowly getting unsure of himself, trying to cling to his older strengths, but realizing he is losing that. That expression came out so beautifully. You feel like, you know, it's a, you know, aged relative of your family. I felt like that, at least. So those are two scenes so close to my heart.
Arnav, what about you?
Yeah, when Sudhisar talked about Dasaratham, yeah. He's stealing the same scene, but thankfully you told about a different aspect of the climax, because that climax is like, I really enjoy that. I'm a, by nature, I like this emotional touch in movies. And for me, when a hero or someone cries, we can see that that person is crying, and it becomes very obvious. Personally, I feel it's very difficult to do two things. One is to cry on screen. Another is to have a good comic timing. And that's what defines a great actor. Here in the climax, when Mohanlal is actually, Rajiv is actually letting Annie go with his son. And then when he is talking to Maggie and he says that, is it the love of mother that Annie shows? Is it that all mother shows? And then he said all of a sudden that, can you love me like that? It was a question mark. And even Maggie was dumbfounded, and immediately he didn't look for a response. He asked. He then, like, at that moment, he felt that he could bust out his emotion by telling that it there was a comfort. At the same time, he started crying as he started walking. Crying as in not as in howling kind of crying. It was an emotional cry. I can pause and I can tell people, see, this scene will make you understand that how great Mohanlal as an actor is. Because that's, and also other than that, so we have discussed so many things. We haven't discussed one particular thing. I know like 1 hour is too less. That's the comic timing of Mohanlal. Yeah. Like even in a comedy like Boing Boing or how it's pronounced?
Nadodikattu.
In that slapstick setting, he made things so effortless. He didn't grow loud when the other characters were acting loudly, making gestures, caricatures. The person who was telling the story, I forgot the actor's name in Boing Boing. He was so loud. It was so loud that I sometimes was going ahead, like forward, but even with that setup, Mohanlal was very effortless. He could pull off that slapstick comedy so well. Even the different kind of get-ups that he was doing in Nadikattu. Sorry, again, I pronounce it wrongly.
Yeah, he
was so effortless in this comic timing, which speaks a volume.
Yeah, I think that's really interesting that you brought up that particular aspect of comedy of Mohanlal. For me, I will not go for one of the more dramatic scenes. I will go for one scene where he is very subtle. And that is where in Iruvar, when it happens that he has been thrown out from the Prakash Raj's party, he gets the news that he has been thrown out and he's in the house. And for a moment, he's sad. You can see the expression and he's sitting and there are so many people, I think press and everything is outside and he doesn't know what to do. And suddenly he just gets his shirt all right and starts walking confidently and goes and opens the door. And he's a totally different person. He gives, okay, this is a payasam, for all have payasam. I'm very happy that they have thrown me out. And so that change in the way he brings to the screen, in the way where he talks about when he goes out there and confidently speaks and makes some light jokes, that particular moment, I really, really enjoy it. So for me, that particular scene from Iruvar is actually very amazing.
I like to add one scene from Iruvar, like one moment where like Prakash Raj was telling Mohanlal, see, this is the frenzy when people were taking his name, that this what needs to become a leader. And on that very next scene, we see Mohanlal wearing a glass. He's speaking in, like first he was like little not confident that will I be able to do it? I'm just an actor. And then the way he was addressing the crowd, Nasir was telling, hey, your friend is Superman. So yeah, I mean that transition.
Yes.
In Iruvar, when Mohanlal transforms into the politician, you know, the last 30-40 minutes,
yes.
He is outstanding. You know, the subtleness of that performance, he is not having that, you know, speed, the pace, that kind of intricacies of only being the actor. He's more matured. He's understanding the politics, the, you know, the duplicacy of all people around him. And the way he's adjusting to that is outstanding in that last 30-40 minutes, I would say.
Yes. I think what is very interesting about Iruvar is that you will find both in Iruvar, the larger than life Mohanlal, the Mohanlal the star during the first half up to the middle, and towards the end you will find the gray side of Mohanlal, the actor Mohanlal comes through when his movements become slow. So I think it is a beautiful package. It's like Mohanlal's range entirely is visible with so much of finesse in Iruvar. One of my favorite Mohanlal movies, of course. Sudhish sir, listening to all of this, if any other scene has come to your mind, you can say.
No, I feel that there are a lot of movies missed, you know. A lot of movies, like when we are discussing about Vanaprastham, we should discuss about Kamaladalam. He's a dancer in that movie. Right. Then we are discussing about Iruvar, we have to discuss about Ori Yatramoli, that he worked with Shivaji Ganeshan.
Yes, yes.
A lot of movies, yeah.
We have to do a part two. We have to do a part two.
Yeah, definitely. No, actually, when he mentioned about comedy timing and all those things, his combination chemistries, you know. we were discussing about this combination chemistry, how he managed with even with Mammootty or other actors like Jagati, Mukesh, with the comedians, and how he managed with the timing and all those things. Mm-hmm. Great. And we missed one great movie, that is Manichitrathal, you know.
Yeah.
It's like that. It's, we have to take the list, each one we have to take list. Then okay, but this is
that, that this movie is we remember more for Shobhana, maybe that's that comes to mind. The first thing that comes to our mind is Shobhana.
Yeah, but then Mohanlal was also great in that one.
Yeah,
you know,
obviously.
Yeah, all did very well in that.
Yes.
Then Irupatam Nootandu, then Moonamura is a like then Naduvaadigal. So many political thrillers like Lal Salaam. And lot of movies like Athiraathram. Athiraathram, Mammootty is the police officer and Mohanlal is the police officer and Mammootty is the villain. Like that. And in that movie, Mammootty's character is celebrated like anything, like Tara Das. Second part came, but it was very bad.
Okay.
lot of movies we missed, you know.
Yes. I think that's natural also, because I do not think, first of all, even from the knowledge point of view, Sudhir sir, it was like talking to a professor. Like when we are talking to you, you are a lecturer, and same feeling came to us. We got to learn so much, so much from you. I think that was truly amazing, and Sudhir sir, this is the first of the many.
And yeah, sure, definitely.
Thank you so much for sparing time for us, discussing with us.
Discussing cinema is always an enjoyment.
And thank you
also on behalf of all the non-Malayalis who would love to hear you, but you know, due to the language barrier, maybe not always get to understand you know, your content in Monsoon Media, which is great. But just our limitation. So we would really like you to continue with few more collaborations with us, because you know, more people will like to hear you and get your knowledge. In this one podcast, we realize how much we need to learn from you, understand from you about cinema.